Hi everybody, I just literally walked in the door, took care of the animals, and got on here to do this video. Alright, remember how I was talking about that I had a feeling that it would be this weekend might be something that we need to pay attention to? Well, I have been absolutely frantic. My insides feel like they're vibrating. So I feel like I'm on spot on this, and there's other people now more or less talking a lot more about it. Okay, so we're going to talk about this again. We're going to talk about some things that you need to get ready. All right, anywhere between Thursday to Saturday, I believe the stock market is going to crash. I believe that you're not going to be able to go to the bank, put your card in the ATM, and pull out some cash. I also believe that you're not going to be able to stick your card in anywhere and purchase anything. I believe that you're going to go to the bank and the bank is not even going to be open. I don't believe you're going to be able to get in there. I don't believe that people are going to accept any form of payment unless it is cash. So let's talk about this and let's be serious. I'm not spreading fear porn. I'm not trying to scare people. If this doesn't happen, then it will be the following weekend. But I'm more than positive it's happening this weekend. Now, remember, I do not get phone calls from any military. Nobody talks to me. Nobody calls me. I don't get text messages. All I do is I trust the energy around me and I listen to God or my guardian angel or whomever you want to call it. That's who I listen to. I believe it is time. I've been telling people on my Facebook page, which I rarely go on, but I did go on there yesterday. Been telling people on my Telegram, get ready. What you have to do is you need to make sure today, do it today and tomorrow. You want to do this. I'm serious. You go get you some non-perishable food. Don't run to the freezer department to go grab a whole bunch of steaks and don't grab a whole bunch of pork chops and stuff like that. Because if the power goes out in this time frame or in October, then you're going to have food sitting in a freezer that you're going to freak out. You're going to have to cook as soon as possible. So don't do that. Don't do that. Only buy what you're going to cook. Okay? So get you some peanut butter. Get you some tuna. Get you some canned chicken. Anything that you can pop open yourself or use a remote can opener just in case the power goes out, which I'm not foreseeing the power going out. But we never know because nothing's going the way that I had thought it could possibly go. And this is a couple of years back. If you go back and you listen to some of my older videos, I've talked about certain things and it hasn't quite happened exactly the way I thought it would. It's taken a lot longer. I thought we were already rolling back the credits a year ago. I didn't know. I think we're on like the extended version. Let's just put it that way. Now, I do believe that there had been a few times where they wanted to end it and they changed their mind. So we're not even going to go there with that. That's beside the point. That's in the past. We're in the future. We're dealing with today and what needs to happen this week. So what I need you to do is I need you to do that. You can get some bread, but you know bread's going to start getting stale after a week. So I would say get you some of the flat fajitas, the corn wraps. Those last a lot longer. Okay, you can get a whole big stack of them for like $2. I would get you a couple of packs of that. You're going to say, well, Jackie, what the shit am I going to do with that? Okay, this is, I got some ideas, right, for you. You can get you a can of refried beans, all right? You can smear the refried beans on that. You can ground you up some hamburger meat, put some taco seasoning on it. You can put a little bit of taco on that and put you some cheese, okay? There you go. Warm it in the microwave. Voila, okay? You're saying, oh, my God. But let me tell you what, when you're in a pinch and you don't have time to really cook and stuff like that, this is stuff that you can go ahead and start preparing and have it ready. Or you can take that can of chicken and you can mix it in the same taco seasoning and you can mix it on some refried beans. You're thinking, well, you know what? You're not going to be hungry. You're really not going to be hungry. These are some simple things you can do. Okay? You can actually eat a pack of tuna out of those little plastic things. You can do that. You don't even have to season. You can just eat that. You can get some crackers. You can eat some crackers with that. What else? Okay, of course, you know, Everything else, you know, like buying your beans and your rice and stuff like that, that's stuff you've got to cook. You can actually cook some of that, put it in your freezer or put it in your refrigerator. You know, that's good for a couple of days in the refrigerator. You can have that. But you want to get things that you just don't want to fill your freezer up is what I'm trying to get at. So get you some simple stuff. The other thing I want you to get, and I'm going to get off this chair just a second. I'm going to show you real quick. While I was waiting for mine to come in the mail, because I get all mine in the big bags, this is what you need to get. Ashwagandha, okay? This, I'll keep capsules in case I run out of my packets, but I ordered two extremely large bags of it. This is what's going to keep you from losing your mind, and it balances you, okay? It works with your thyroid, but it will balance your moods, okay? So it will keep you a little bit calmer. You need to get you some. So when you go to the store, go get you some of this, okay? You need to get two bottles. This was 60 capsules. You take one a day, that's 2 months. Get you two bottles of it in case you need to take one in the morning, one in the night. It's not going to hurt you. I wouldn't take more than that, okay? You get you some of that. That's going to keep you calm. You may have to give it to your kids. It's not a drug, so it's not like an antidepressant, all right? It's not. So if your kids are acting all wacko, you can give them some of this too. It's not going to hurt them. It's natural. It's herbs. It's just stress support. It's what it is, okay? Not going to hurt anybody. You don't have to take it on an empty stomach. You don't have to take it on a full stomach, okay? Just get you some. Trust me. It keeps me really, really calm. And this is how I completely got off my antidepressants and my anxiety medicine. That's what did it. There's a couple of other herbs I take as well. I believe that help. But we're not going to go into a whole long list of herbs that I need to show you that you need to get for depression. But this, go get you some, okay? You can get it at Walmart. I don't think it's at Target. Or was it at the Target I saw when I was up in Hattiesburg, Mississippi? But you can probably get it at, you know, you can just go online and look and see which local drugstore has it. If you want to order it and you're thinking, well, maybe I can get it before Friday, you can try iHerb.com. iHerb.com. They carry it and just get you some, okay? But I highly recommend trying not to have anything sent in the mail, because I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know if they're going to start slowing down the postal service. We don't know. So you don't want to have something stuck in the mail. I can't tell you. I just feel like people are going to be really crazy that morning they wake up and nothing's working. Bills aren't going through, the automatic payment, nothing's working. I think people are just going to literally freak out. Because it's going to be a whole across the whole United States, I don't think that people are going to really go out there and start evicting people, because it's not just going to be one particular person or just one particular city or one particular part of the country. It's going to be all over the United States. So I don't think that the courts are going to allow people to file the paperwork and to call the police to come evict you out your homes. Or now, that does not say that the electric company may not want to keep your electricity up, because we know they're assholes. That's just a given. I've yet to find an electric company that's really nice and carry. Phone bills, that might be kind of iffy. So you definitely want to make sure you've got some electricity until we shut down and then come back up for that. So you want to make sure you've got your electricity, and you want to make sure that you've got your phone in case you need to call and check on people. Now, do I mean that people will not go to work? That's going to depend, because if nobody can buy anything because nobody has any cash, stores aren't going to be able to stay open for their period of time and pay people to stand there and not do anything. They're not going to make any money. They actually lose money, because they're having to pay those people on the hour. So if they don't have income coming in, they can't justify someone standing at a register. So there's a possibility that some businesses may cut their hours, might only open up for a little bit and then close down. It may be because people can't afford to come to work. They're afraid they can't get any gas in their car, anything like that. So I'm not sure how that's going to work with going to work. That's why you need to do it today. I, unfortunately, am kind of stuck. I don't get my paycheck until Thursday. So there's not much I can do till Thursday. So I'm hoping that maybe I'll get a few people to ask for a card reading or something, and I can get a little bit of money in, and then I can do it tomorrow or Wednesday. It's really my goal. I don't need a whole lot of money. I just want to make sure I've got a decent big bag of cat food, and I want to get a couple of more two more bags of tortillas and a couple more cans of the canned chicken, and anything extra, I'm going to go ahead and zip it on my electric bill. But that's it for me, of course, gas. But yeah, I don't really need a whole lot. So hopefully today, some people are inquire about card readings, and that'll help me a lot. But as far as that, I'm not panicking, but I really wish I had more money to do it today. But you do yours today, definitely by tomorrow. You want to make sure that you're ahead of the game, because you don't want to stand in long lines. You don't want all that panicking and freaking out. Now, Restore Republic was saying this morning that it could last up to 10 days before the banks open up and you're allowed to get in there. So let's just say, for safety reasons, let's say 14 days that you may not be able to get into your bank. That's just a safety, okay? We're hoping it takes less. We hope it don't take longer. So let's say about 14 days. So that should bring us into about the second week, maybe into October, right about there. So I think everybody be pretty well safe. Now, while this happens, I do not know if they're going to do any arrest or if anybody's going to have to step down. I'm not quite sure. But I will tell you, there's a reason why they were showing those 17 cities. And we've talked briefly about this. If you live in one of those cities, or you live in a high crime area, you already should have been making up your mind. What kind of plan can we put in place? We may need to get the shit out of Dodge. That's because you're going to have people that, you always have a group of people that loot and tear up property for no reason. The sun's shining too bright today, and whatever. They got to go out and destroy some buildings. I don't know. I don't know about these people. I have ideas. I don't think all of them are just possessed. I think some of them just think the shit's funny, and it's not funny destructing the property. It's not funny. My cat wants me to hold her. So if she jumps on me, I'm going to have to hold her. She's old. She's almost 20 years old, so we're not going to be mad at her. But so if you live in one of those areas, you may have to get out. Do know, if people are desperate, because there are going to be people that don't have any cash, maybe don't have any groceries in their home, maybe they got to feed their kids, I don't know. When people get desperate, they do some really crazy stuff. So someone may start breaking into going to nice neighborhoods and trying to break into homes and just to steal the food. You don't know. But like I'm saying, you don't want to be someone who's not prepared for this. All right? I don't know if this is the event that is going to mark the martial law, where the military will take over. They're already in charge, but for us to see that they've taken over. I don't know if this is the event. I don't know. I can't imagine anything worse than a bunch of people freaking out, screaming and hollering and, pulling people out of their cars when they see they have groceries in there. I don't know. That also reminds me, when you go to the grocery store, make sure that you got your car open, you get those bags in there, and take somebody with you if possible. And don't be lingering around, tinkering and looking at your phone while your bags are sitting in the buggy, whatever. Get your shit out of the buggy, in the car, lock your doors, and get out of there. Don't stick around. You don't want somebody coming up grabbing your buggy or grabbing your groceries out of your car, or even grabbing you. We don't know what people are going to do when they get desperate. Okay? And this even goes for people who actually have cash on them and they're trying to shop while this is going on. That is going to be the worst time to go shopping. I'm going to tell you that right now. That is going to be the worst time. That's when you don't want to go shopping, is when no one else can buy anything and you actually have money on hand. So do your shopping beforehand. All right. So now we know that this is probably going to happen. I am pretty sure that this is going to happen. This is going to be the event that is going to really wake a lot of people up. When the banks open back up, we will be back under the gold and silver standard. That is in the original Constitution, people. This is not just something that the White Hats decided out of the clear blue sky. If you read the Constitution, which I keep telling people, you have to do this. It clearly says that you are to pay your debts with gold and silver. So you're supposed to be paying Joe for whatever you're buying with a silver coin. You're supposed to. But they took us off of that because they can't control that. The Rothschilds and all of them, they wanted to control the money. So they had to take us off that so they could get the inflation. Oh, gosh, I'm draining. Sinus is draining. Hold on. Had to get us off of that so they could control the money and inflate it so they could make more and more and more. When we go back under the gold and silver standard, that's going to stop inflation. You're not going to have every so many years, you know, oh, I used to buy this for $5, now I got to buy it for $20. No, that's gone. That's gone. That's inflation. That's ridiculous. It's going away. That's how come the prices, they're up here, and they're going to start going all the way to 1955. Will not be overnight, people. So don't expect when everything happens, you're going to walk out the door and it's going to be 1955 prices. You're going to be doing backflips because it ain't happening that fast. It's going to happen. But it's going to take a little bit of time. It could take 6 months. It could take a year. I don't see it taking more than 2 years. But in that time period, you're going to notice the prices are going down, 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 down. The housing market is going to crash. So all these people that going around buying houses that were in foreclosure, thinking they're all smart, because I'm telling you, the person that got mine, she thought she was smart too, and I tried to tell her, I said, please don't do this. Let me work with you. Let me stay in this house. I want to be in this house when this goes on because I feel safe here. I'm not going to feel safe anywhere. And she's like, oh, no, you know, whatever she said. She was from one of those islands, Spanish-speaking islands or something. Oh, no, that's not happening. I know the law. I come to this country and I know the law. I know the law. No, you don't understand. I'm in my legal right. You don't know. You have to, this is going to happen, whether you like it or not. You have to leave. You could have to leave. That's how she did me. So I'm giving her a phone call when the stock market crashes. So anyways, all those people that are buying all these houses thinking, oh man, we're going to be rich. We're going to be rich. They're going to find out, like I told her, I said, you're going to find out. You're going to lose money. You are going to be sorry that you've done this to people. Instead of working with them and trying to help them through this after I'm telling you what's going to happen. I even showed her tapes about maritime law, how the Constitution wasn't being right and how they're not doing what they're supposed to be doing. She did not want to hear it. She didn't want to hear it. I told her that the IRS were illegal, that they're actually committing crimes by forcing people to pay their taxes and for people to be paying taxes when you are completely, you decide if you want to pay taxes. It's voluntary, but you're forced to pay it. And I was trying to tell her this stuff. She's like, oh, you know what they're talking about. So anyway, that's why I'm going to give her a call because I'm going to tell her. I tried to tell you, I'm going to say, now you need to get me out of this apartment. You need to get me back either in my house or you need to get me in a house. Get me out of here because I want out of this apartment. I really do. Now, whether or not I stay here in the state of Mississippi, I think I want to move to another state. But I want to get out of this apartment. I need a backyard. My dog has got to go in a backyard, really. So I got to get out of here. I'm too cramped. Everything's in boxes. I feel little. I know I'd feel much better and I would probably pick up the energy and get better visions if I wasn't so confined. I feel like I'm in a box and I feel like I'm this all the time. So I don't feel like I'm getting everything that I used to get. I used to get it really good. And I just feel like because it's just so clustered and everything's in boxes and I have no room for anything, it's ridiculous. I mean, the kitchen is just god awful small. You put two people in there and you're crowded. I can't take it. I need a little bit more room. I know I'm one person, but I need a little bit more room. And I want my son and my grandson back with me. And that's what I want. I know that's going to happen. That will manifest for me. But I got to get out of here. I got to get out of here. So, I'm not sure, but like I said with anything else that's going to happen, but I don't know if that's the event that's going to do that. But like I said, the housing market is going to crash. These people that are buying all this stuff, they're going to be having all these properties. that are going to be zeroed out just about. They're not going to be able to sell them at $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 like they thought. I told her that. I said, my house, when it goes down, I said, that's going to be worth under $10,000. And she just looked at me. Because she's like, oh, no, you won't be able to pay for it. It'll be too expensive for you. I'm going to fix it, be expensive. I said, no, my house is going to be worth under $10,000, I'm telling you. So, yeah, the housing market will probably be the first thing that we see the drops much faster and get inexpensive the fastest. I'm excited because if I can't get my house back, I am getting another house. I've got to get out of this. So all those people, they've got it. Ooh, they got it coming. So I believe the housing market will be probably the first thing that we see the prices really drop faster. I think used cars prices will drop much faster. Maybe a lot faster than the new cars, but I think the used cars, the prices are going to drop probably a lot faster. That's just what I see happening. But as far as everything else, it will catch up and everything will be at 1955. So thank you, Jesus. Thank you. There's no reason why anybody's going to be suffering or struggling. There's not going to be any homeless people because it's going to be redundant. So let's get back on hand. So when this happens, I do not know if they're going to arrest Biden and Harris and Pelosi and all of them. There's a possibility it could go down during this time. I'm not for sure. Like I said, I don't know if this is going to be a big enough event where the military has to come out and start policing. I don't know. There's a possibility. Now, we do know that there will be 3 days of no power because they got to get us off this grid onto the Tesla. We know after that, it's 10 days of classes that they're going to put on the TV. I'm thinking that will happen in October. But some people keep saying, like I was listening to another news, and they were saying that they're going to let, I hate saying that, but we're just going to say this is what they said, not what I say. They were saying that they were going to let them see if they were going to steal the midterm elections, and if they stole it, then the military was going to go in, double check, see how many illegals had voted, how many people voted more than once. And I'm reading this and I'm thinking this is not going to happen in November. That's going to take at least 2 more weeks if they're going to allow this to go on. So now we're looking at December. And I'm like, no, no, I wanted this to happen last year. I don't want to wait till December, January for the military to do all the searching on this and then say, oh, well, it was all illegal again. We've already got an illegal election as far as I'm concerned. Now, some people say no. I say yes. It doesn't matter. Point is that I think that it should start happening in the end of October going into November. So I do not see elections happening in November. I just think that would be the most ridiculous thing to have us go through not being able to get to our money in the bank, us freaking out, panicking, screaming and hollering, and then have us vote to find out that the military's got to investigate everything and then put all that out. I think that's just too much. I think when they do it, it just needs to go like that. I think it just needs to keep going. You know, you're already there. Let's not here, break. I think that's too much for people. I think people will just say, you know what, I can't handle this. I gotta go. That's what I think. I think once we do this financial crash, I think that should start triggering everything else. That's what I think. I don't think it'll be immediately. I think while this is going on, I think we may see some arrests. I think we may see the more stuff with the fake World War III. I think we will see Trump come back into office. And I think we will see it just go and just shut down all the way where we're confined to our homes and this happens. I think that's the way it should go. That's the way I hope it goes. Because this doing this break, no. That's too much for people, especially elderly people who are confused and still live at home and try to take care of themselves. That's too much for people that have got small kids that are trying to handle them and handle what's going on. No, let's just do it. All the way, let's do it. That's what I'm hoping. That's what I want you to hope for too. Because trust me, you don't want a break. Just do it. Keep doing it. You don't want breaks. So That's what we hope, but that's not what I'm hearing. I'm hearing that they'll probably go ahead and do elections. I don't want that. I really don't. Let's just not even have elections. So I want you to be prepared that that is the possibility that could happen. It could just keep going. So you also want to make sure that all your laundry is done. You don't want any dirty laundry. You don't want any yard work. If you were planning on, pressure washing your driveway off, you need to do that today. Please do it today. Do it tonight. Don't wait. Do all that nitpicky stuff now, because you don't want to be outside. You don't want to be going places that you don't need to go when people are freaking out. And I'm telling you, people are going to freak out. If you're on my Telegram channel, you'll see the videos I post of people fighting in restaurants over, I don't know, ketchup. I don't know. Fighting over stupid stuff. People purposely cutting other people off on the road, pulling over, and then they start fighting in the middle of a highway. I mean, people are losing their minds now. Just add them not being able to get to their money and just understand how people are going to be. You think that's bad now, what they're doing? Wait. No, you don't want to be out in that. So, no, you want to be home, safe, locked in your home, got a chair up under the doorknob, whatever you got to do, make sure that you're okay. Because it's going to get bad. You don't want to be out there. So you want to make sure your kids have got something to do. And I'm not talking about video games. I don't want to talk about making sure that you got a whole bunch of movies for them to watch. Get some board games. Get a deck of cards. Get some paint by numbers. Get something creative, you know. And try to act like it's not bothering you. And laugh and sing and joke and stuff like that. And then the kids will laugh, sing, and joke. All right? So I would get some board games. I'd get something like that, puzzles, I don't know, Pictionary, anything, Scrabble, get you some games, and play with the kids, play with your kids, okay, play those games with them. If they want to play a cup of tea with Barbie and Ken, play with them, just do what you got to do, and act like everything's normal, just act like it's kind of like a vacation, so you're not putting any stress on the kids, so the kids don't start acting up and screaming and hollering and being all cuckoo, because that's going to stress you out worse, and you've got to be calm through this, all right? So start planning all that. Make sure your dishes are done, make sure you've got enough pet food, make sure you've got your medicine, if you take prescriptions, and you've got another prescription, call your pharmacy and say, hey, I'm going out of town. It's an emergency. I'm going to be gone for about 4 weeks. Can I go ahead and get my prescription filled early, please? Pharmacists will a lot of times do that. Or if you need to call your doctor to get a prescription refill, tell your doctor you're about to go out of town. You need to get your prescription refilled because you're going to be gone for a little bit. Have your doctor call you one in. Whatever you got to do. So if you're on prescriptions, make sure you've got enough. Because what I'm saying is you don't want to have to go out and go get that stuff. Think of anything you possibly could need. You should have plenty of water. Go to the dollar store, get you some pitchers and fill them up. Put them in the refrigerator. Put them on the counter. Put them somewhere. I've taken ice chests and some HelloFresh boxes. And I filled them up with bottles of water. So that's filled. My refrigerator's filled with water. So make sure you got plenty of water, plenty of non-perishable foods, plenty of pet food, your medicines. Make sure that you've got your toilet paper. Make sure all your laundry's done. Make sure anything that you possibly could need, you've got. Also, make sure you've got enough AA and AAA batteries. Make sure that you've got a couple of flashlights. Make sure you've got that just in case, because we know the power will be going out soon enough. So make sure you've got that. Make sure you got gas in your car. And if you've got a container that you use to put gas in for your lawnmower, fill that up with gas. Fill it up with gas. That way you've got extra gas. Things like that. Make sure the housework's all done. Vacuum, shampoo, mop. Scrub your bathroom now. Don't wait. Just do everything now. Because you want to be focused on keeping your mind off what's going on when this goes down. Like I said, I cannot say for certain that this is going to trigger the military coming in and then trigger the 3 days and then the 10 days. But I think that we will start seeing some arrests. I think we will start seeing some people stepping down. I think we could possibly start seeing some military actions on our streets. So that's what I want to stress to you. I don't know. I don't. But I know that the financial's about to crash. I know that's coming. That is coming. I can just about almost put my hand up, put my hand on this Bible and tell you that I believe that this weekend, right here, I believe this weekend that the financial system is going to crash. That's how confident I am that this financial system is crashing this weekend. That's it. I'm serious. I could be wrong. I'm not saying I'm 100% right, but I believe. And for me to believe it, and I'm usually pretty spot on with stuff, take it for what it's worth, okay? Take it for what it's worth. Just get yourself prepared. If it doesn't happen, you're just like, well, we're good. We got lots of groceries now, and the house is clean. Hey, we can do something this weekend. Whatever. Don't get mad if it doesn't happen. Just be glad that someone reached out to you and told you. But what I'm saying is just be ready, be prepared, be ready for anything. Think of everything. Think outside your box. Don't just stay in your little bitty thing and think, well, my dad was that way. He was that way. Daddy, no, we got to think about this. We got to think about this. My dad had gout when he had his throat cancer. And his feet, like one foot would swell really big and the other foot wouldn't. So he couldn't wear his shoes because he couldn't put one on his one foot. And he's like, I don't know what to do. I want to go to work. I want to do this. And so it just hit me, bang, in the face to go get a big pair of shoes, bigger than his foot size. I got like two size bigger. And then when his foot would act up, he said, I can't put my shoes on. So he would put the one shoe on, and then I would go get the other one that was bigger. And he says, I'm not wearing that. That thing's too big. I said, Daddy, just trust me and put the damn thing on your foot. He put that on his foot. He says, oh, my God, it fits. He said, I'm so sorry, Jackie. He says, you are so smart. So that's what I'm saying. Don't stay in your way of thinking. Think outside the box. It might look stupid. It might sound stupid. But if it works and it saves your life, then it's worth it. So quit worrying what people think about you. Quit worrying, oh, people will think I'm crazy if I do that. Do you really care? With everything that's going on, do you care? Someone that you don't know, that will never ever see you again in your life, thinks you're crazy. Do you really care? Because that should be the last thing you care about. I don't care if someone thinks I'm crazy. I don't care. I don't live for them. I live for me. I live to take care of these animals. I live to see my child and my grandchildren. That's what I live for. Some complete stranger that thinks I'm crazy or thinks I'm talking smack or wants to do something ugly or say or spit on this screen at me or whatever. You think I really care? With everything that's going on, you think I care? No. No. Why should I care? I don't care. And if I don't care about it, you shouldn't care about it either. Who cares if you're doing something crazy outside, getting prepared for this, and someone goes, wow, that's a crazy ass neighbor over there. Don't worry about it. Because I tell you what, when you're prepared and they're not, they're going to say, I should have did what he did. He was smart. That's what they're going to say. So don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about what people think about you. Quit worrying about that right now. Just don't worry about it. We've been taught to worry about it. We've been taught that we should set a very good first impression on people because that's how they're going to judge you, by the first impression. They're going to judge you by what you wear and how you smell and your hairdo and how you wear your makeup. So everything should be perfect so people get that perfect first impression of you. Why? 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 Are they going to live with me? Are they going to take care of me? Are they going to support me? Are they going to want to be my best friend? Why should I care what a group of strangers think? At this point in time in my life, 55 years old, I don't care. I don't. And I'm glad that I grew out of caring as I got into about my 20s. My dad was wanted me to be very proper. I mean, I was in balls. I did the whole curtsy thing. I had to wear formal. I gave out trophies at horse races. I did all of that debutante stuff. I did. I had to. That's what my dad wanted me to do. And because I love my dad, I did what my dad asked me to do. Had my hair always perfect. Had my makeup always perfect. Dad said, you're losing too much weight. I'd go run and jog and all that kind of stuff. Now I don't care. I don't care. I'm not trying to impress anybody. I don't care. You shouldn't care either is what I'm trying to get. If it saves your life, don't worry about, oh my God, I think I'm going to die. I better make sure I've got a beautiful dress on. What? What? Really? Who cares? Stop it. Just stop it, please. Stop caring about it. Take care of yourself. So start thinking seriously about what I'm saying. We should start seeing something. You're probably going to hear more and more about it on Wednesday, definitely on Thursday. I'm not sure if it will be Friday morning. But if it's not Friday, it should be Saturday. It would be stupid for it to be on a Sunday. But I honestly think that it's going to be Friday. I really do. I think people are going to get up Friday. And I'll be surprised if it doesn't happen Friday. If it doesn't, I'll be like, okay, one more day, one more day. But yeah, it's this weekend. It's the 24th. It's this weekend. So just be ready. Be prepared. Don't freak out. Be calm, cool, collective. Act like this is no problem. We got this. This is good. Be that way for your kids. That's why I'm saying if you got all of your housework done, you know, you can completely focus on them. And the more you focus on them and you're keeping them calm and you're singing and you're dancing, act like nothing's going on, doing your thing around the house, playing games, playing hide and go seek, stuff like that, the kids are not going to know anything's wrong. They may be wanting to know why you want to spend so much time with them, but they're going to enjoy it. And this keeps them from noticing what's going on. And the more they don't know what's going on, the calmer they are and the calmer you can be. It's supposed to last maybe 10, I'm saying look anywhere for 10 to 14 days. So somewhere around that second week of October, the bank should open back up. You should be able to get into your accounts. Now, whether or not the money from Quantum, we start seeing something about it or hearing something about it, I'm not sure. I'm not expecting any money from the SARA in our banks. I don't, but I would be shocked if we did. You never know. Like I'm saying, I don't know. I don't really know. But just be prepared for anything. Be ready. Be prepared. This is a warning. You can take it or you can leave it. You can ignore it. You can flip me off. I don't care. I'm trying to help. So heed my warning. Just be ready in case. But I'm pretty sure. If you're on Telegram, there's a lot of different people that are showing the proof that they believe that it is this weekend. And like I said, the Simpsons are always predicting things and it happens just the way the Simpson cartoon predicts it. Simpsons are talking about the 24th. So be ready, guys. This is a little bit under an hour. I think that's perfectly fine. I don't think we need to go any farther. If anybody would like a card reading, please leave a message here. Get me on Telegram. Send me an email. Like I said, I'm not charging people $250 for their card readings. Do know if you do a card reading that it is most appreciated. I love doing card readings. I love helping people. And you're helping me. Like I said, I'm just going to go get a few things at the store. Nothing elaborate. Just to be ready. So if you know someone that wants a card reading, let them know. I know there's a lot of people online that do card readings live on YouTube, and I've listened to them, and they're charging $250. I'm not doing that to you. I'm not doing that to people. So if you know somebody that really wants a card reading and they just don't want to pay $250, send them over my way, and I'll take care of them. Like I said, I usually do a general reading. I pick up on what's going on your subconscious more. I'm noticing that. I haven't really picked up on anybody's past life or too much into their future. It looks like I'm picking up on their subconsciousness right now. So I've been helping people work through those issues when I've been doing card readings. So just send them my way. Okay, guys, you have a great day. You're going to be busy today and tomorrow. So get to it. All right, bye.